Oh, hey friend, it's Monty, back with another Character Spotlight, this time covering Maya Lopez, aka Echo, a fantastic character who appears in the Hawkeye series and is even getting a spin-off of her own coming to Disney+. But who is Maya Lopez, and what makes her such a unique and special character? Follow me after the jump and find out as I spotlight Echo. Echo first appeared in Daredevil number 9 in 1999. Created by David Mack and Joe Quesada, she's a very unique character, not only being a Native American of the Cheyenne Nation, but also one of the few deaf characters in comic history. When Maya was a small child, her father, Cheyenne gangster Willie Crazy Horse Lincoln, was killed by his business partner, who is later revealed to be Wilson Fisk, aka the Kingpin. As he was dying, he reached for Maya and left a bloody handprint on her face, an image that will stay with her for the rest of her life. Willie's last wish was that Maya be raised well, and Fisk honored this request, caring for her as if she was his own flesh and blood. Believing Maya to be mentally handicapped, she was sent to an expensive school for people with learning disabilities. One day, a concert pianist is brought in to play for the school. It is during this performance that Maya taps into something. She is fascinated by the dancing of the man's hands, so she walks right over to the piano and puts her hands on it, feeling the vibrations coming from it as she matched them to his hand movements. As soon as he was finished, she jumped on the bench and duplicated his entire hand play exactly. Maya was not mentally disabled, she was a prodigy, a person with the ability to mimic anything she sees. Upon finding this out, Wilson Fisk spared no expense moving her into special schools for gifted children and getting her the best tutors to help her develop her gifts naturally. By the time Maya reached adulthood, she was a celebrated concert pianist, performance artist, boxer, and more, having learned a magnitude of skills with her body doing everything she asked of it. You may think that she is very similar to the Taskmaster, with her ability of mimicry, and that she was created based off of that villain. However, you would be wrong. David Mack and Joe Quesada have both stated that their intention was to create a character that was just like Matt Murdock, a character that was his equal in a lot of ways. Both of these characters are positive heroes for the disabled community, with Matt being blind while Maya is deaf. When we get the reveal that Kingpin has been the man raising Maya, we also learn of a new plan that he has hatched. He plans to hurt Matt Murdock by attacking what he perceives to be Matt's weakness, the desire of not being alone, of having someone to fill the emptiness. So yes, the Kingpin is planning to pimp out his adopted daughter to Matt to destroy him from the inside. Like, dude, just punch him really hard in the face or something, because this is like next level weird. Despite the cringe of this plan, Fisk really does love and care for Maya, and has trained her through her studies to be quite the formidable person. She loves him also, believing Fisk to be nothing more than a legitimate spice dealer. Kingpin knows that she and Matt will fall for each other due to their shared life experiences, and he sends her in his direction for legal consultation. Fisk tells her that Matt believed he was a bad person and that she was the only way to prove him wrong. As Maya believed him, it would not appear to be a lie when she told this to Matt Murdock. During their meeting, Matt is totally charmed because Maya is adorable and smells really good. Plus, Matt is also profoundly vulnerable right now. He's still reeling from the tragic loss of Karen Page. Plus, Daredevil is like a total himbo. Obviously, Matt and Maya fall in love, and with her life in a good place, she asks Kingpin if he can finally tell her who was responsible for killing her father. And he obliges. He tells her that Daredevil killed her father. Having a specific person to blame has a profound effect on Maya. She does her best to process this new information through her art in a one-woman show she writes and choreographs called Echo. This is the first time we see her don the white handprint on her face, which is a representation of the bloody handprint her father left all those years ago. Facing the pain through performing is not enough for Maya, and she chooses to set off on the path of revenge. To prepare for the task ahead, she watches numerous videos of Daredevil battling Bullseye, and there is actually a specific reason for this. While Kingpin may be the Man Without Fear's true arch nemesis, it is Bullseye that is physically equal to Matt on many levels. Bullseye is one of the most capable fighters in the Marvel Universe, and has mastery of multiple forms of hand-to-hand combat, weapons, and projectiles, which has put him on equal footing with Matt Murdock, even beating him at times in hand-to-hand combat. Taking what she has learned, Maya confronts Daredevil for the first time, the white handprint on her face symbolizing her need to make things right. She's more than a match for the Horned Hero and is able to best him with the intention of killing him. However, the fight is broken up by the appearance of small children, Maya choosing not to subject them to the sight of violence. This time she chose an environment where his heightened senses would be useless because she noticed that he was moving too easily through the dark, showing just how formidable she is. Just before she's about to kill the New York vigilante, she notices a cut on his face that matches the same one that Matt Murdock had. She's finally able to recognize Matt, and she begins to unravel all the lies that Kingpin has told her with his help. Maya finally realizes that Wilson Fisk is her father's true killer, and she takes this information with her for a heated confrontation between the two, where Maya ends up shooting Wilson Fisk right in the face, thinking that she killed him. We find out later, however, that he survived the attack, and she merely only temporarily blinded him. After realizing the horror of her actions and the lies she has grown up with, Maya fled the United States for some much-needed soul-searching. When she eventually returned to New York, she went to Matt to reconcile, only to find that he was already with someone else, the blind woman Mila Donovan. She also finds out that the Kingpin survived despite her attempt on his life. She goes to see the Kingpin in prison only for him not to blame her for what she did, and despite all that happened, he still loves her like a daughter. Finding no peace in her return, Echo leaves New York to go to her father's reservation and visit the Chief, who is an old medicine man that was friends with her father. After listening to Chief's stories about her father, Maya decides to follow his suggestion and goes on a vision quest. On her quest, she meets and befriends Wolverine, who helps her recover and pass on knowledge of Japanese culture and Japanese organized crime. Soon enough, Maya makes peace with her past and returns to New York and begins her performance art yet again. The next major developments of Maya's story come from Brian Michael Bendis, who really helped to weave the character into the larger Marvel Universe amongst its new status quo. At this time, Marvel was going through a bit of a reinvention as the events of Avengers Disassembled and House of M changed the landscape of the Marvel Universe. The Avengers were no longer around as they were, and the mutant population was vastly diminished. The new Avengers were formed when Electro turned off all the electricity at the Raft and caused a massive breakout to occur, resulting in 42 supervillains successfully escaping. All of the heroes present at the breakout formed the new Avengers, with the intention of tracking down and locking up the escaped villains, one of which was Kinoichiro Harada, the Silver Samurai. Captain America reached out to Matt Murdock for help because it appeared that the Hand were attempting to use Harada to unite the underworld of Japan in a unison of the Hand, the Yoshida clan, and the Yakuza. Matt, being unable to join the Avengers for personal reasons, recommends someone to Captain America who would be perfect for the job. This person is Maya Lopez, who Matt schools on the Hand, Yakuza, and Silver Samurai before her meeting with Captain America. Maya, after experiencing a recent identity crisis and feeling unable to join the new Avengers due to a refusal to tarnish the reputations of the heroes by working alongside them, dons a suit that conceals her identity as well as her gender, and rechristens herself Ronin, which of course is Japanese for the phrase Masterless Samurai. This actually marks the first time the Ronin suit and name had appeared in the comics, which makes Maya the originator of the name later used by Clint Barton. It was in Japan that she infiltrated the Yoshida Fortress only to learn that the Hand and Hydra were now in a partnership and were trying to influence Harada to join and lead them. Maya was unable to successfully escape the fortress undetected, and she was attacked by dozens and dozens of forces from all three factions. The fact that Maya was able to hold her own for as long as she did amongst some of the most skilled ninja in the MCU shows just how amazing she truly is. She respected Captain America's wishes by attempting to kill as few of them as possible, but in this situation, she was left with very little choice. She valiantly made it back to the Avengers penthouse in Japan, where she attempted to relay all of the information she had learned before the Hand arrived. The Hand finally catch up and a battle ensues, with Maya heroically fighting alongside the new Avengers, defeating Hydra and the Hand, with Madame Hydra being arrested when all was over. After joining the Avengers, Maya arranges with Captain America for her to stay in Japan and watch the Hand's activities, hoping to resolve the conflict between them and the Yakuza. and because she heard rumors that Elektra might currently be the leader of the Hand. At this point, the Marvel Universe was shifting again, as after this, the events of Civil War played out, with Maya being gone for the entirety of them. We learn the reason behind this is because she did find Elektra leading the Hand, and Elektra killed her, but only so that she could revive Maya using the ways of the Hand, and then give her drugs to control her mind. This was all found out by the new team of New Avengers, led by Luke Cage. They were able to rescue Maya before the effects of the drug were fully able to take control. The new Avengers aided Maya in her fight against the Hand, and in retaliation for everything that they did, Maya kills their leader, Elektra, in combat, only to have her body revert to its true form, revealing her to have been a Skrull all along, which kickstarts the events of Secret Invasion. Maya would remain with the New Avengers after the incident in Japan, with Clint Barton, who was using the Ronin identity at the time, offering her suit back. She tells him to keep it as a gift for coming to rescue her along with the others, officially passing the mantle on to him. After helping against the Skrull invasion, Echo's next major appearance would be in Moon Knight, where she would pop up in Los Angeles doing undercover work, blowing her cover when Moon Knight attacked a meeting she was in. She helped Moon Knight uncover the identity of the Los Angeles kingpin of crime, and the two began a relationship. During their final confrontation with the revealed Count Nefaria, Echo is seemingly killed, which causes Mark Spector to snap, submitting to his Wolverine personality and killing Nefaria. You would think after announcing her appearance on the Hawkeye Disney Plus series, Marvel would have concocted a huge story to put Echo in the limelight, to pique the interest of new fans. The sad truth, however, is that Marvel largely forgot about her, and the stories that she was most recently involved in have not been great. Mainly her winning a tournament and being deemed the ideal choice by the Phoenix Force to be its next host, which kinda goes against everything we've known about the Phoenix up until this point. I am hopeful, however, hopeful that we will see big things from Maya Lopez in the future. Her start at Marvel Comics was fantastic, full of amazing stories and great character work. I hope her boost in popularity from joining the MCU and getting her own spin-off series provides us with a resurgence of talented writers telling amazing stories with this great character, because her voice is one that deserves to be heard in modern comics. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe for more content. Also, smash the like button and comment down below if you're excited to see Maya Lopez kick serious butt in the MCU. Until next time, guys, I'll catch you later.